kind of beautiful thing right here?
It is beautiful.
Video keeps going back over there.
Because open it, Pete.
Pop DJ
back on one, twos. I promise you it's been a lot smoother in practice today. Hang on there.
I don't think it's a song, Bob. Okay, Ghost Rider. That's definitely not the God.
Thank you. change his life. The floor is yours, my friend.
All right. Hey, my name's Derek.
Hey.
So, how God has changed my life in a big, huge way is like, let me see. Let's put it like my grandma, you guys know she has cancer. And so if he was not in my life or her life, I don't think she would have been here.
Amen.
But I just don't. Amen. But since he's in my life and in her life too, she's working. She's doing it.
Come on.
God has done for you and how he's changed your life.
Okay, so a few years ago, my grandma was diagnosed with prostate cancer, and it's been a really hard time for us. And so last summer at church camp at James River, it was during the worship time, and the preacher asked for us to ask God to fulfill us with the Holy Spirit. And so I asked him, and then a few seconds later, I was fulfilled, and I started speaking in tongues. And so that's, I know now that God is powerful and amazing. And so every day I pray that he will keep my granddad with us. And so far he has. And I'm just thankful for God and what he's done in my life. Yeah.
Amazing grace, how sweet. Amen.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by his side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when the face is before me. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. What will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Oh, and all you be still, will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only
But, you know, I wish, I'm not say anything about where I went to church when I was a kid, but the youth group that I was in, I never really felt challenged, you know, to just be all that I could be for God. And so that's what I'm doing with these kids. That's what I feel led that God is challenging me to do, is to challenge these kids to go deeper into their faith, to look for the answers, to seek, knock, ask, look for the wisdom, look for, well, basically, look to this. Because this is where it's at. Is that right? Basic instructions before leaving earth, B-I-B-L-E. If you're not in this, as we talked about quite a bit, you're missing out. And you're not going to know what's going on. In Jeremiah chapter 1, it says, the word of the Lord came to me saying, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. That right there, right off the bat, I mean, wow. Before I was even anything, he knew me. And he knew you. He knew your name. He knew everything about you. And he has a plan and a purpose for you. He goes on to say, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. And good old Jeremiah says, ah, sovereign Lord. He said, I don't know how to speak. Because why? I'm too young. I'm only a child. Rubbish. Rubbish. In fact, that's pretty much what God says. The very next time around, he said, but the Lord said to me, do not say that I'm only a child. Do not tell me that you're too young. You must go to everyone I send you and say whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them. For I am with you and will rescue you, declares the Lord. Then the Lord reached out his hand and touched my mouth and said to me, now I have put my words in your mouth. See, today I appoint you over nations and kingdoms to uproot and to tear down, to destroy and overthrow, to build and plant. Wow. Guys, what do we do? That blows my mind. But you know what I hear there? Purpose. We all got it. You know, Pastor said something this morning about, you know, it's not just about, you know, those who are in the limelight, those who are in the ministry. We talked about this a little bit in the youth group. You know, it's not just about the pastor or the leader or this or that. We all have a ministry. Every single one of us has a ministry. God wants to use every single one of us. There is nobody in here that he doesn't want to use. Amen? Nobody. I don't care who you are. It doesn't matter. He wants to use you in a mighty and powerful way. Look at Jesus. Look at what he did when he came to this world. He flipped it upside down. And that's what we can do. That's what I'm telling these kids, is purpose. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Plans not to harm you or to destroy you, but to give you a future and a hope. Amen. Say what? Amen. A future and a hope.
Amen.
Have we not been talking about hope lately? Have we not been talking about mustard seeds this morning? I'm here to tell you right now, this will light your life up. It will light you up. And I'm telling you right now that there's purpose for each and every one of us in here. Now, I don't know everybody. I don't know your life. I don't know the struggles. I don't know the things that you're going through. But let me tell you something. God knows.
Right.
And whatever you're going through, you're not going through it for no reason. There's a purpose and a plan for everything that happens under the heavens. Everything. He is working all, capital, A-L-L, bold, italics, underlined, as Mariah always points out to me. Right? All things to the good of those that love him. All things. purpose for our lives. And I wish I would have grasped that at such a young age. But I didn't. I threw it away. But praise God, I'm still here.
Amen.
And it's because of Him. It ain't got nothing to do with me. The only thing that I did was make a choice. But how else could I make that choice? Just like Pastor said this morning, I had to be called. Somebody had to come and tell me. Did you know that each and every one of us in here is a missionary?
Right.
As soon as we walk out that door, that's the mission field. You don't have to go to Africa. You don't have to go to Asia. I'm not saying don't go there. If God calls you there, then by all means go. Don't be like, well, JC said don't go to Africa. Now, you can't use that as an excuse. So one of these days you stand before the Lord and say, why didn't you go to Africa? JC said so. My point, and I apologize, I have trouble standing still, but I'm very passionate about this. You ask the kids, man, when I'm in the youth room, I'm just like, man, I mean, I'm everywhere. I do get my exercise. My I love these kids. I'm so thankful that I go to a church that loves and supports their youth. Because let me lay something on you real quick. They're the next generation. They're the next church leaders, pastors, missionaries, husbands, wives, moms, dads, teachers, doctors, lawyers, whatever it may be. But if we don't send them out of here with a solid foundation, then shame on us.
Right.
That's our job. It's everybody's job in here. It's not just my job. It's not just Travis's job. We all can do it. And let me tell you something else. Just because you're not a parent doesn't mean that you can't be one to somebody. You can be a mentor. These kids, dadgummit, man, these kids need us. They need God. They need to see Jesus in us. God forbid I do anything to stand in the way of the Holy Spirit. Anything. For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. People. Man, somebody give me a nap or something.
Man.
I'm going to be one of the pastors that has to have a handkerchief. If I ever reach the point where I get to be a pastor. Listen. Within me there is nothing good except God.
Amen.
Okay? And if there's anything I do that is good, it ain't me. It's all Him.
Amen.
Right, Robert Jones? Right, Travis? Word up. And yes, I've tried very hard to not use my vernacular this evening so you can understand what I'm telling you. But I'm about to go into it because it's very hard for me not to do it. Listen to that. Let that marinate in your mind for a minute. For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Not to destroy you, not to harm you, but to give you a future and a hope. Seriously, let that sink into your mind for a minute. Just let it marinate. Gosh, if you'd asked me when I was their age that I'd be up here doing this right now, I'd have laughed in your face. But nonetheless, here I am. Why? Because God's got a plan. My plan was bogus. My plan was junk. But His plan, though, led to life. Abundant life. Real life. And if there's anybody tonight that does not have that abundant and real life, you can have it right now.
Amen.
It's free. It's already been paid in full. We just talked about this Wednesday night. It's paid. So I challenge you, as I challenge these youth, and let me tell you something, I challenge them. Man, we get into some weighted discussions behind closed doors. And it gets real. But that's good. I want it to get real. It needs to be real. Because this God of the Bible, the God of Isaac, Abraham, and Jacob, he is real. Because I know what he's done in my life. Let me tell you a little bit about what he's done in my life. Here I am. That's what he's done in my life. Here comes my vernacular. Wild out. In other words, I just did whatever I wanted. You know, I grew up in church. I was there Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, Tuesday night visitation, and any other time the door was even cracked open, we were there. I was dragged kicking and screaming most of the time, right? Like some of you probably were. But let me tell you something. Praise God for my mom taking me to church. Because that's the foundation that even though I walked away from it, I came back. And let me tell you something. We got foundations to build. We talked about it this morning. The kingdom of God is here. It's available. We are kingdom people, are we not? A royal priesthood. And this is what I love about God. He says, for you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. There is none righteous, none who seek after God. We don't come out the womb and be like, where's God? Where's he at? Do we? No. But yet, in his great love and his predestined plans, he sent his son to die for a wretch like me. Somebody who used to wild out all the time and get drunk and get high and do all them stupid things that I used to do. And yet here I am teaching these kids. It's all him. So you can't tell me tonight that you don't have a purpose. And anybody who walks up to me and tells me that, you're wrong. You know why you're wrong? Because God said so. You're wrong. So I just challenge you. I encourage you. What's the saying? If God is for us, if God is for us, if God is for us, do you believe that tonight?
Amen.
I do. You know, the other day, man, I was burdened. Of course, again, those of you who follow me on Facebook, I pretty much put my whole entire life on there. But you know what? Travis touched on something this morning. It's not about us. And there's people that I work with that are hurting. And they're going through some really tough stuff. Divorces, sicknesses, death. And it was weird. I was just overwhelmed with a brokenness. I was sorrowful for these people. We are to weep when others weep, are we not? And I couldn't help myself. Because I knew all these people that have come to me and talked to me about their problems, none of them have the hope that I have. And it killed me. And if anything, it caused me to step back and take a look at my life. Instead of, you know, oh, well, they don't have Jesus and they're blah, blah, blah. No, actually, it caused me to look at my heart. It caused me to look at myself. And it just broke me. I can honestly say that that's probably the first time in my life it's ever happened. I just wept. Right there in the middle of work. I mean, I was on my lunch break. I wasn't like on the phone or something. What the fuck? I'm putting them on hold, letting them listen to the elevator music, right? But then something else came to my mind. These kids. love each and every one of you.
But God loves you more. And I want you to own that for yourselves. Because in this life, there will be trials. There's going to be tests. There's going to be tribulations. There's going to be things that are going to be tough. I've been through some, as all of you have too. Maybe going through some right now. But there's good news, right? Take heart. For I've overcome the world. We are more than conquerors. Correct? You, KAOS Youth, you are more than conquerors. And as it says in Timothy, don't let anybody look down on you because you're young. I'll have words with anybody that does. Because I'm telling you right now, it doesn't matter what age you are. Crap said this, well, age ain't got nothing to do with it. Age is just a number. This is eternal. This is real. And this book is relevant. It does speak to today's issues. I promise you it does. That's why it's living and breathing. This is an active document. It's not just a historical book, and it's not just good literature. Okay? This is real. Power. Do you hear the power in that? For I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Plans not to harm you or destroy you, but to give you a future and hope. Do you hear the power in that? Whew. Holy Spirit, speak. I thank you so much, Orchard Crest Baptist Church, for allowing me the humble privilege to lead these kids. And I thank you for letting me get up here tonight and sweat all over the pulpit. And I thank you for letting these kids have a night to themselves to just be themselves. And I'm hoping that this is going to happen a whole lot more.
Amen.
Let me tell you, real quick, I'm going to close this thing up. If there's anybody here tonight, I almost hate saying that, it's like so cliche. If there's anybody here tonight, but it's true, that doesn't know Jesus as their personal Lord, Savior, friend, King, Rescuer, Redeemer, if you don't know Him like I know Him, then tonight's your night. You don't have to wait. Oh, hey, by the way, good news. You don't have to clean up either. Come as you are. Come on. What are you waiting for? Water spot, I come on in. This is where the party's at. Have you not seen that tonight? Did you not see how much fun these kids was having? It's all about God. That's right.
He's not dead.
He isn't dead. He resurrected from the grave. And because of that, we now have victory.
Hallelujah.
Say that with me. Victory.
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 That's what I'm talking about. That doesn't, it's fine if you're off. So,
hashtag turn up.
Hashtag turn up. That's right. So again, guys, I thank you. Very, very much so. Thank you for taking the time to listen, for taking the time to be here to support these kids. I know that many of you are praying for them. Please don't stop, because they are dealing with battles every day. We all know that this world, it ain't getting no better. And they're having to deal with stuff that even when I was in high school, back in the mid-90s, Wyatt, I don't want to hear nothing from the teenagers in here.
About what?
There was stuff going on
but not like it is today. And not blatant and not just all over the place and out there like it is today. And it's not just me that needs to be living it out in front of them and talking to them. I need all y'all's help. Every single one of you in here can speak life into these kids. We all have a mission. We all have a purpose. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for listening. I mean, wow. What a night. I think God showed up tonight, didn't he?
Amen. Amen.
Thank you for this night, for the fellowship, for the fun, for the party, for the celebration of you. Lord, I thank you for each and every youth that is in this room. You know the plans that you have for them. God, I pray that you would make it known to them in a major and mighty way and move on their hearts. Move on all of us, Lord. We all need a move of the Spirit in these last days and times, Lord. Father, I just thank you for who you are. I thank you for your Son. I thank you for sending him to die on the cross for mere human beings that are undeserving of it, Lord, but yet love found a way. And I thank you for that, God. Lord, thank you for this church. Thank you for these people. Thank you for this opportunity to be your humble servant. And I just pray again, Lord, that if anybody doesn't know you as their personal Lord and Savior, as their friend and Redeemer, that tonight will be their night. Again, Lord, thank you. I just ask that you go with us the rest of this week. Protect us, Lord. Meet the needs, God. There's so many requests, so many things, Lord, that we need you desperately, desperately, Lord. We long for you, God, in your presence. Thank you again, Lord. I just ask all these things in the name of your Son. Amen. Amen.